Why did we work so hard for so many years just to, you know, give up and go straight to video? Hell no. So we went out, we released it ourselves.
It's either now or never.
You go out there and you compete against, you know, every single weekend, there's another two or three major Hollywood movies coming out, as well as another half dozen independent films coming out, you know? I mean, how do you make your movie stand out from all the rest?
I gotta hand it to Gene because he was a one-man machine. Basically, he did everything. He was the accounting department, he was the marketing department.
Any metropolitan area that had 20,000 Filipinos and up, we actually did the research. And so we targeted 15 cities across the country that had populations that met that criteria.
March 16th, 2001. San Francisco just represented in a big way. It was amazing. That opening weekend, you saw people coming out from every nook and cranny of Northern California.
Oh my God, is this it? And then like the next show, it started getting bigger and bigger, and eventually we were selling out shows.
And it didn't stop just that one weekend. The next weekend, we did it even more.
Hearing that I'm gonna go home and bring more people to come, that was always a good thing to hear. People just coming up and buying merchandise. It was kind of cool when they asked for your autograph too.
It was a community event. It wasn't like just watching a movie. It was an experience.
Basically, the demand was so great, we ended up having to open up a theater a week. And we did that until we ended up 8 weeks into the film. We had 8 theaters open in every nook and cranny of the Bay.
We were in the number one movie in the movie theater, and we were beating all these major Hollywood films.
It was like a David versus Goliath. Sometimes a part of me was saying, hey, I wish someone from Hollywood could just sit down and take my place for a night and see exactly what's going on here. We're up against Jurassic Park 3, America's Sweethearts, and Virginia Beach.
We grossed over $20,000 our opening weekend, and we were the number 50 film in the country with only one theater, you know?
The debut coming to Virginia Beach was huge. There was like parties even going on that weekend, but no one was showing up. Everyone was watching the debut.
I basically started hiring as many people as I possibly could.
We were looking for people who had no lives, you know?
We were looking for losers.
We were looking for people who didn't have commitments in their lives, like mortgages.
Now, when we have like a group of like, you know, six, you know, 8 people, it seemed harder.
And so we ended up with 9 full-time regional coordinators in Los Angeles.
I was working at Filipinos for Affirmative Action, and I ran a youth program in Oakland. Being that I organized so long in the Bay Area, I was actually interested in learning what it's like organizing in other parts of the country.
We needed someone like Melanie because she really organized us in terms of just getting everything together.
So she came on board and basically started organizing all of our contacts for us into these really big, huge, detailed databases.
Basically, it was a 24-hour gig.
You wake up in the morning, you check your emails.
In schools, if he's in high schools, you have to do presentations.
Going to specialty colleges.
And look for stores and put posters and flyers.
Promoting the church is the most frightening thing. You know, I did like my little spiel about supporting the debut, and I turned to the priest and I go, hey, how about the man upstairs? Does he give him a thumbs up? And the priest goes,
we're in the theater every single day, so we know exactly who comes to our theaters. We introduce the shows.
Are you guys ready to see some Filipinos up in the big screen?
I didn't feel like a filmmaker anymore. I felt like a salesman.
There are always those people who are, number one, affected for the rest of their lives by this movie.
And it's really great how someone can come up to you and they thank you personally for making this movie, and they have tears in their eyes. People are saying like they actually changed their majors or changed their career goals because of this film.
The greatest show I've ever seen.
Oh, thank you so much.
I'm trying to tell my whole school and my whole church and my whole everything.
You couldn't spend money for rental cars and all this other kind of stuff. So everybody drove from city to city. Here we are, a bunch of Filipino kids in our cars, caravanning across country, driving through Gallup, New Mexico, and Tulsa, Oklahoma, and Springfield, Illinois, you know, in the middle of the snow or in the middle of the heat.
The cross-country trips were really, you know, frightening.
The fact that we actually drove around the country was crazy, right?
Well, yeah, but distributing the film itself was crazy, right? That's what everybody said, it was crazy. Making this movie was crazy to begin with.
I'm never gonna imagine driving to Chicago, driving to New York ever in my life if it weren't for a good cause.
We couldn't afford to stay in hotels. And so basically, in every single city we would go to, we ended up staying on people's couches at a host family, you know, like exchange students. We would make it a mission to seek out the best restaurants in every single city that we went to, and that's how we
Hawaii.
Actually, we all gained a bunch of
Hawaii.
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 I didn't feel like a tourist because for 2 months, I lived in the area, I drove around the area, I got to know the streets, I got to meet the community leaders there.
We go to places where like the locals haven't even been to.
We were giving people directions, actually.
Yeah.
we don't have a big budget for marketing and advertising, so we really rely on the word of mouth.
We were so spoiled by the Bay Area and by the great numbers we had that any like numbers below that would be a disappointment.
You can't really control the vibe of a city, but you feel kind of responsible for the outcome of that certain city, how many people show up as a direct result of your promoting.
For an independent film with no advertising budget and no support from Hollywood, we did really well in every city we went to, but we still always came across people who were ashamed of being Asian.
Or would get angry at us for promoting something that was proud to be Filipino-American.
Supposed leaders of the community who don't even show up, who are supposed to be like, you know, the movers and shakers.
And that was difficult, because we were working our butts off out there trying to promote this film.
It's like you've thrown a big party and nobody decided to come, you know, and that hurts.
A lot of people assume we were recording a movie from the Philippines. I'll just wait for home video, or I'll wait for my friend's bootleg copy.
Sometimes you would see like the high school students, the youth, just like feel really, really angry towards their community. At the same time, they were learning. It just made them want to do more.
There's one thing that really motivated us on a daily basis was just our volunteers.
When times are really rough, they help keep us going.
You know, it's amazing because you hear all the excuses. Well, it's too far. Oh, it's this. Oh, it's that. Well, Houston's a perfect example of how all those excuses don't mean anything.
We only had one theater.
We had one theater that was centrally located right in the middle of Houston that everybody could get to, and people drove from all around to this one theater.
People even drove from Dallas to New Orleans.
We grossed almost $2 million at the box office and sold all these t-shirts, and they think that we're all rich. Mm-hmm. But the reality of the matter is every single city was a struggle just to break even. Mm-hmm. And that's the reason why people need to understand that they can't take movies about our communities for granted. They don't just pop out of nowhere.
We just touched so many people on this tour, and every city will remember that.
That's what this is all about. We're trying to empower our community. The Filipino-American community, the Asian-American community, people of color in general. We're making a statement with the debut. However small this little movie is, and you know, 300,000 tickets in the grander scheme of things is not that much. But given that we had so little resources to work with, hopefully it's a small little statement that we're here, we demand to be counted, and we want to see more movies about us.
It's very humbling after the tour, and you like have to move back to your parents' house too. that killed it.
How did you all learn to get along with each other on the road? Because
I don't get along with anybody. No.
Yeah, Jonesy.
This is the first time we've been together. You know?
Yeah,
it's hard. It's hard being with three women on tour, you know.
They have their own period, so we just said, all right, let's go.
My menstrual cycle is in tune with it.